and as a direct result of that, the scooter started being used again. Slowly, over about a period of about 2 or 3 years, the mod image was sort of tapered out. It used its usefulness as far as this kind of rally is used. But people with an interest in scootering, people who become scooter enthusiasts, basically through being mods in the early days, were left with the love of scooters. And so now that's how things like this have materialised. The love of the scooters being left as an aftermath of the mod revival.
At the rallies, glossy custom paint jobs and engraving has replaced the chrome and mirrors you used to see on scooters in the 60s. But the embellishments are just as lavish. One of the best machines this year is Spirit Walker. It cost £5,000 to create.
Started with a rusty white Lambretta, bought it for 25 quid from Southend, and started from there, took it home, stripped it down completely, sent all the paintwork off to be sandblasted. Then when that came back, I sent it to Paul Carslates to be sprayed. The main theme of the bike is the cult, the band. Their main sort of theme and their music and things is North American Indians and the symbols and, you know, their sort of lifestyle. So the Indians on the bike go with from the band.
Every part that can be is lovingly engraved, and that exhaust system is going to be a very expensive replacement. The decoration on the back wheel includes, would you believe, diamond studs. Now, rich Arabs often want gold door handles on their Rolls Royce, but a gold-plated carburettor and a speedometer head on a scooter. Of course, you don't have to spend £5,000 to make your scooter a winner, and this one just costs £1,600. James Dean is the subject, and of course the name of the scooter had to be Rebel Without a Cause. Some machines are stripped down till they look almost like bikes. All the bodywork's old Lambretta has been cut down, and the frame has been cut and stretched too. The end result is really reminiscent of the Easy Rider machines beloved of the old Hell's Angels.
Darling, you got to let me know, should I stay or should I go? If you say that you are mine, I'll be here till the end of time. So you got to let me know.
Most of the scooters you see at the rallies are the Italian Vespas and Lambrettas. Will the Japanese Hondas and Suzukis ever catch on?
In the commuter market, yeah, but not as part of the scootering scene. They just don't have the credibility. They don't have the lines. They don't have the classic Italian styling. It's probably what it boils down to. They leave a lot of plastic on the Japanese scooters. They're just horrible.
Some of the Italian scooters, like this Lambretta, are now becoming sought after.
It was first registered in 59, which makes it about 27 years old. I bought it from a village near where I live in Newmarket for £50 on the promise that I'd return it once I'd restored it to its former glory. Since then, I've put it into a custom shows. I took second place in one and first place in another. And I'm really proud of it, the response it's got on the rally.
But the Italians didn't have it all their own way. This BSA B2 was the 1959 British response, which can still be seen on rallies. The bolted-on side panels meant it looked good, but the little vents weren't enough to cool the engine, and its 70-mile-an-hour top speed meant it would overheat, and you could only get inside by the seat. So the Italian machine stayed in front. Engine size and power outputs increased, but such changes cannot explain the appeal of this unlikely machine.
I'd love them. I couldn't really pinpoint the actual reason. I was back in the 70s in the revival as part of the mod revival, and that left me with a loving for scooters. But since then, I've done silly things on them. I've driven to Spain and back on a scooter. I've driven from Lanzin to John O'Groats in a day on a scooter. It's just a constant challenge. It's a poke in the eye for society, if you like.
So if you want to become a scooterist, there's over 1,000 clubs to join. Get your dad's old machine out of the garage, and the next scooter run, well, might be Morecambe in March.
Well, I must say this is rather